Blessed is our God, always, now, and forever, to the ages of ages.
Amen.
Glory to you, our God, glory to you, Heavenly King, Comforter of the Spirit of Truth, who are present in all places and filling all things, the treasury of blessings and giver of life, come and abide in us. Cleanse us of every stain and save our souls of evil.
Amen. Holy God, Holy Mighty, Holy Lord, have mercy on us. Holy God, Holy Mighty, Holy Lord, have mercy on us. Holy God, Holy Mighty, Holy Lord, have mercy on us. Glory to the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit, now, always, and forever, and ever. Amen. All Holy Trinity, have mercy on us. Lord, be gracious to us in our sins. Master, forgive our transgressions. Lord, we consider our weaknesses in the open for your name's sake. Lord, have mercy. Lord, have mercy. Lord, have mercy. Glory to the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit, now, always, and forever, and ever. Amen. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil.
For thine is the kingdom, and the power, and the glory of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit, now forever, and to the ages of ages.
Amen. Lord, save your people, and bless your inheritance, grant you victory to the faithful, and grant mercy to the protector of your commonwealth by the cross. Glory to the Father, and the Son, and the Holy Spirit. Lifted up on the cross by your free will, Christ, God, grant mercy to the commonwealth of your name, glad and happy to close by your power, giving the victory of your adversaries. May your alliance be for them a weapon for peace and invincible standard, now and always and forever and ever. Amen. Awesome and unfailing protection, do not turn our supplications, gracious and all praise to the Lord. Uphold you with us, commonwealth, preserve those you have called to govern, and grant the victory from on high. For you, the only blessed one, give words to God.
Have mercy on us, O God, according to your great mercy. We praise you, hear us, and have mercy.
Have mercy, have mercy, have mercy.
And we pray for all pious and Orthodox Christians.
Lord, have mercy, Lord, have mercy, Lord, have mercy.
And we pray for our Archbishop and Father Saba.
Lord, have mercy, Lord, have mercy, Lord, have mercy.
For you are a merciful God, who loves mankind, keenly ascribe glory to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit, now and forever, and unto the ages of ages.
Amen. In the name of the Lord, Father, give the blessing.
Glory to the Holy, consubstantial, life-giving, and undivided Trinity, always, now, and forever, and unto the ages of ages.
Amen. Glory to God in the highest, and honor, and peace, goodwill to men. Glory to God in the highest, and honor, and peace, goodwill to men. Glory to God in the highest, and honor, and peace, goodwill to men. O Lord, open my lips, and my mouth shall show forth your praise. O Lord, open my lips, and my mouth shall show forth your praise. O Lord, why does many taunt me, many others who rise up against me, many who say to me, there is no salvation for human is God. But you, O Lord, are a shield around me, my glory, the one who lifts up my head. I cried out to the Lord in a loud voice, and from his holy mountain he heard me. As for me, I lay down and slept, and I woke, but the Lord will give my help. I will not fear 10,000 people arrayed against me all around. Arise, O Lord, and save me, my God, for you have stricken all who hate me without cause, who shattered the sinner's teeth. This is the Lord upon your people, be your blessing. As for me, I lay down and slept, and I woke, but the Lord will be my help. O Lord, in your anger, rebuke me not, chastise me not in your wrath. Your errors are poured into me, and your hand weighs heavily upon me, because of your wrath. There is no soundness in my flesh, and there is no peace in my bones because of my sin. For my iniquity step over by me, they have weighed upon me like a heavy load. My sores have become stench, festering because of my faults. A stupid and exhausted wreck, I stumble morning of the day. My bones are burning with heat, for my life is totally mockery, and there is no soundness in my flesh. I'll crush the heat, be afflicted, I'll work with the groaning of my heart. O Lord, my longing is known to you, my groaning is no secret to you, my heart races, my strength has left me, and even the light of my eyes has failed me. My friends and companions approach and stood by one of those who kept me kept their distance, of those who sought my life, were right down, of those who wished to be healed by the body, body and deception all the day, that I remained as a deaf man, and heard the knowledge of that man, and opened not my mouth. This man was not heard a thing, and thus was very short upon his lips. In you, O Lord, I place my trust, you will be healed, Lord, my God, I said, that my post ceased to look over you, and blessed remind me of my greatest trouble. As for me, I am ready to be scourged, and my pain is with me always. Indeed, I myself confess my guilt, and I will live in anguish because of my sin. But my enemies survive, and they are powerful, those who hate me without cause are multiplied. Those who render me evil for good, but for myself to justice. O Lord God, forsake me not, stay not apart from me, hasten to help me, deliver my salvation. In you, O Lord, I place my trust, you will be healed. O Lord, my God, hasten to help me, deliver my salvation. O God, my God, with all my cries to you, my soul has thirsted for you, and only how my flesh is hungry for you. Like a desolate tract of sand, I have no water, so that I come before you in your holy place, and see the power of the Lord, they are yours. Since your love is better than life, which is for your grace, they shall my flesh as long as I live and lift up my head to call upon your name. My soul shall be filled with joyous spirit, and joyful lips will praise your name. As I lay on my couch, I remember you. I remember. great jacket they shall be, that the king shall rejoice in God and always swear by him, shall be over the mountain higher than the stop. I meditate on Mr. Archer and watch us to be able to help the women in the shelter of the wings that will find the light. My soul clings to you and your right hand, hope to God. Glory to the Father and the Son and the Holy Spirit, now and always and forever and ever. Amen. Hallelujah, hallelujah, hallelujah. Glory to you, God. Lord have mercy, Lord have mercy, Lord have mercy. Glory to the Father and the Son and the Holy Spirit, now and always and forever and ever. Amen. O Lord God, my salvation, day and night, I cry out before you, let my prayer reach out to you, let the prayer to my plea, O Lord. For my soul is filled with trouble and my life gave us the haze that was right with us, good God, the dead, I was like an enemy, my house left dead. Like a slain left behind the grave, as you remember no more, but you're cut away from your hand, you have cast it down to the deepest of distance, darkness, and the shadow of death. You're under the burden of my need, for your doors to open, and took my heart away from you, and devotion to them. I was closed in, but not escaped my gosh, because it was distressed. I cried out to you, O Lord, all the day I stretched out my hand to you. Oh, you were martyrs to the dead of composition, praise the God to sing your praise, but then we'll sing your love, and we'll be able to do the tradition. Turn along the criminal and darkness of the justice in the land of the living. And yet, O Lord, I cried out to you, and you do my first shall rise upon. Why, O Lord, you reject my prayer? Why do you hide your face away from me? I'm wretched in trouble from my youth. I was very high to
you.
I'm
a distressed. Your places are filled with me, your chairs are kept in shape, they surround me like waters all the day, they close upon me from all sides. Yet distance me from my friend and neighbor, my acquaintance is so wretched and one. O Lord God, my salvation, day and night I cry out to you. Let my prayer reach unto you, and hear to my request, O Lord. Bless the Lord, O my soul, may all that in me bless his holy name. Bless the Lord, O my soul, and forget all the gifts of him. Who pardons all your sins, and heals all your infirmities. Who ransoms your life from corruption, and crowns you with his love and mercy. Who fills your longing with what is good and your youth with me like demons. The Lord appoints me to the kindness and vindication for all your hearts. He has made known his ways to Moses and his wills to Israel's children. The Lord is one of compassion and mercy, all suffering and manifold love. His contention is not forever, nor was any always last. He has not dealt with us in our sins, the man, nor does he repay our iniquities. For as high as the heaven and stand over the earth, so far as the Lord extended his love for those who fear him. As far as the east is from the west, so far as we remove our sins from us. As kind as the Father is to his children, so is the Lord to those who fear him. For he himself knows how we were born. He remembers we were only made of dust. On the end, his days resemble grass, as a flower of the shall be food. But let our griefs pass over, and he needs God, and never shall he know his place again. But the love of the Lord is from all eternity to all eternity to those who fear him. And his justice is upon his children of children, who keep his covenant and remember his laws for him. The Lord has established his throne ahead, and over all things his kingship is supreme. Blessed are all of his works and strong and mighty ones who obey his word on hearing the sound of his decree. Blessed are all of his powers, his attendants, and obey his word. Blessed are all of his works and every place in his dominion. Blessed are all of my soul. Blessed are all of my soul and every place in his dominion. O Lord, hear my prayer and treat this to be to my being in righteousness action. And enter into not in judgment with your servants and all of it and us in your sight. The enemy is present. As the enemy is going to be down, he has crushed my life into the ground. He has forced me to live in darkness like those long dead. My spirit begs to breathe, and within me my heart is in despair. I recall the days of old, I meditated on all your deeds. I pondered the works of your hands. I stretched out my hand to you like a parched hand. My soul thirsts for you. In case I answer you, O Lord, my spirit has failed. Turn off your face away from me, lest I be let go in the pit. Grant that I may hear you confess out of the mouth where I place my hope in you. O Lord, teach me the way I should go, for I have kept my soul. O Lord, deliver me from my enemies that you have kept. Teach me to do your will, for you are my God. In your good spirit, in my straight path, for the sake of your name, O Lord, you will keep me alive. In your righteousness, you will deliver me from affliction, and in your loving kindness, you will destroy my enemies. And bring on all those who oppress me, for I am your servant. O Lord, give every way to you this to be, to my being, in righteousness, and sanctity. And may your good spirit give me on straight path. Glory to the Father and the Spirit, now and always and forever and ever. Amen. Hallelujah, hallelujah, hallelujah. Glory to you, God.
Hallelujah, hallelujah, hallelujah. Glory to you, God.
Hallelujah,
hallelujah, hallelujah. Glory to you, God, our hope.
our deliverance from all affliction, wrath, danger, and necessity, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, have mercy.
Help us, save us, have mercy upon us, and protect us, O God, by your grace.
Lord, have mercy.
Commemorating our all our most holy, Lord, blessed and glorious Lady, Heaven, help us and ever Virgin Mary, with all the saints, let us commend ourselves and one another, and all in our whole life to Christ our God. Most wise Anthony and also Saint Ephemius.
spirit within. Do not cast me away from your presence. Do not turn me. Do not take your Holy Spirit from me. Restore me to the joy of your salvation. Uphold me with your guidance. I will teach your transgressions your ways and the ungodly son of our God. Let every man who loves the weakness of God to God by salvation, and my tongue shall bring you towards your righteousness. O Lord, you shall open my lips and my mouth will declare your praise. For you desire a sacrifice, I will give. You will not be pleased with all burnt offerings and sacrifice of God, broken spirit. A broken and humble heart, God will not stop. Do good, O Lord, to your good pleasure and desire, and that the walls of Jerusalem will be built. Then they will be pleased with the sacrifice of righteousness, with offerings and all burnt offerings. Then they shall offer him bulls.
O Lord, you made the hosts of God-bearing saints shine into creatures of godliness and silence those of godlessness, and they lit up the entire earth by their entreaties. Preserve us in peace as we glorify and magnify you and chant and sing to you, Alleluia.
Thank you.
Company
Eternal life with joy to that end. just bow our heads unto the Lord. We have said both for our attention to the good of God, and we have granted us work to earth and heaven. Yours it is to show mercy and to save us, O our God, to give us our glory to the Father, to the Son, to the Holy Spirit, now forever to the ages of ages.
Amen.
Wisdom,
Father, blood.
Blessed is he who is Christ, our God, always, now and forever to the ages of ages.
Amen.
Lord God, strengthen the holy through faith and the power of us Christians together with this holy church, the city and parish, and the end of the ages.
Amen.
Most holy Theotokos, save us.
Born, born, and share with God, and hear my voice in this day, and you have come to give birth to God, Lord. Do birth to you, Lord God, and magnify you.
Glory to your God, our hope, glory to you.
Glory to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit, and now and in the age of ages. Amen. Lord, have mercy, Lord, have mercy, Lord, have mercy, Father, and bless us.
May he who is wondrous among the saints, Christ, the true God, through the intercession of the spotless Holy Mother, by the power of the precious and life, and the cross, protect me out of the power of his power, spend. Came on the glorious prophet and forerunner of the battle, the only glorious praise of the apostle, the glorious triumph of martyrs, for venerable God, the ascended fathers. Our Father, among the saints, John Christopher, Archbishop Constantinople, the liturgy we celebrate. The holy righteous ancestors of God, the Joseph of Ghana. The holy, glorious monastic saints who have excelled in asceticism, Theophanes the Confessor, Simeon the new theologian, and Gregory the Theologos, the bishop and pope of Rome, whose memory we commemorate today, and of all the saints. He's a good and merciful God and blessed mankind. Through the prayers of our holy fathers, Lord Jesus Christ, our God, have mercy upon us and save us.
Amen.
Good morning. I just want you to be aware, I'll be making this announcement a couple times. The book that I am holding in my hand right now is the Divine Liturgy of St. John Chrysostom. Nothing majorly special about that. Are these names? Beautiful. Nothing majorly special about the fact that we're about to do the Divine Liturgy of St. John Chrysostom. Blessed is the kingdom of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit, now and forever, and unto the ages of ages.
Amen.
In peace, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, have mercy.
For the peace from above, and for the salvation of our souls, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, have mercy.
For the peace of the whole world, for the stability of the holy churches of God, and for the unity of all, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, have mercy.
For this holy house and for those who enter it with faith, reverence, and the fear of God, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, have mercy.
For all pious Christians of correct glory, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, have mercy.
For our Archbishop and Father, Savas, for the honorable President, agony of Christ, for all the clergy and the people, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, have mercy.
Y para que vayas a luz con él, y su prado, pasas a ti, que exercias a la fortuna y con él.
Lord, have mercy.
Y para que espolos a ti, pasas por los que corras, que tu piste me punta en la testa, y con él.
Lord,
give him a
power.
God by your grace.
Lord, have mercy.
Commemorating our all holy, pure, most blessed, and glorious Lady, the Pale of the and Ever Virgin Mary, with all the saints, let us commit ourselves to one another in all our life unto Christ our God. Promise that we, when two or three agree in your name, you will grant the request. Fill now, O Lord, the petitions of your servants as may be of benefit to them, granting us in the present age the knowledge of your truth and in the age to come to the Lord. For you, O God, are good and love mankind, and to you we offer up glory, to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit, now and forever, and unto the ages of ages.
Sanctify our souls and bodies, and grant that we may worship you in holiness all the days of our lives,
through the intercessions of the holy Theotokos and of all the saints who please you throughout the ages. For you, our God, are holy, and to you we offer our glory, to the Father, to the Son, to the Holy Spirit, now and forever, and to the ages of ages.
In order to be seen in them, for then they will have no
streets, that they may be praised by men. Truly I say to you, they have received their reward. But when you give alms, do not let your left hand know what your right hand is doing, so that your alms may be in secret, and your Father who sees in secret will reward you. And when you pray, you must not be like the hypocrites, for they love to stand and pray in the synagogues and at the street corners, that they may be seen by men. Truly I say to you, they have received their reward. But when you pray, go into your room and shut the door and pray to your Father who is in secret. And your Father who sees in secret will reward you. And in praying, do not heap up empty phrases as the Gentiles do, for they think they will be heard for their many words. Do not be like them, for your Father knows what you need before you ask it. Pray then like this: Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be your name. Your kingdom come, your will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from the evil one. For yours is the kingdom, and the power, and the glory, forever. Amen.
Glory to you, O Lord. Glory to you.
Please be seated. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Christ is in our midst. So far, within the Divine Liturgy, it will be very difficult to pinpoint, oh yeah, this is different. You know, as I said before, the book that I am using for the Divine Liturgy, it says the Divine Liturgy of St. John Chrysostom, but we have to remember that in this country, we're very young. You know, it's not a very old country in the first place, just a couple hundred years. And Orthodoxy in this country is still that old, but, you know, the translations of the Greeks within this country are even younger, much younger. So we're still developing, and that's what this book that I have at the altar table is. It is a new translation given to us by the Archdiocese, and, you know, they're encouraging us to use it. Now, they're passing it out to us now, which means that if you know the liturgical cycle, I only have probably about three times to do this, you know, before Holy Week, because we're doing the liturgy of St. Basil for the remainder of this you know, Lenten season on Sundays. So you know, it's going to be very difficult to kind of incorporate this translation, but we'll do our best. What we are doing today, though. I know if I ask everyone what today is, everyone's going to say Sabbath of Souls, which is what we're celebrating, right? You know, this is what we're doing. This is the second. One last week, we're doing one this week. But if, as our chanter and our neocordos here will tell you, as they're starting their services, daily orthos, like a daily orthos during the Theodian period, which starts with not the Theoskia, Theoskia, Pethon, and Mimi, the way we started our orthos today. It starts with Alleluia, kind of the way we do, you know how we come to Holy Week, and you know, we, Ecclesiosa, Fisico, Plema, you know, and they have this long, drawn out Alleluia. There's prostrations, and then Iduomim Theos, right? You know, we have that whole thing that happens during the bridegroom services of Holy Week. Well, the reason we do that is because a weekday Orthros for a just a run-of-the-mill Saturday or a run-of-the-mill non-Sunday during the Theodian period has those Alleluia verses. But this did not begin that way. This began with Theoskedios, which means already from the time that we're doing Orthros, this is a festal period. And what is the feast that we're celebrating today on the second of our Saturdays of the Souls? The feast that we're commemorating on the second Saturday of the Souls, according to the Theodian, is the feast day of all the monastics, all the ascetics. Every single person that has devoted their life in a very specific way. Not the martyrs. Some of the monastics were martyrs. Some of the ones that actually lived in monasteries eventually became martyrs. We know that. But not specifically the ones that were martyred. Just anyone that was a monastic. Anyone that was a monk or a nun. Throughout our history, throughout the church, we commemorate them in a blanket statement across the board today. On the Saturday before Jesus' first Sunday. And there's a very important reason for that. And the reason is so that we can understand, first of all, what it means to really commit ourselves to Christ. The monastics aren't better than us. They are what we consider to be, as much as we can, the fulfillment of what we are trying to do in our own lives. Okay? It's not that they are better. They are living a life more strictly. They would say, you know, what was it? Abba Pieman, St. Pieman, the monastic, he was one of the greatest ascetics that's ever lived. And somebody said, are you a monk? And he said, I'm not a monk, but I've seen some. You know, in other words, he was saying to himself, I don't think I am. I don't think I am a monastic, but I've seen a few. I'll show you a few. The monastics don't look at themselves as better. Okay? They look at themselves as people who are trying to live out the gospel the best way they know how. Gee, that's funny. That sounds familiar. That's what we're trying to do. We're trying to live out the gospel the best way we know how. And we're trying to do that within the world, and the monastic would look at us and say, you have a harder time than we do. Because you're filled with all the world, with all the temptations, with all the struggles, with all the whatever. We left. We couldn't handle it anymore. Not out of weakness did they leave. They were called to this life. So they're not walking a road that's better than ours. They're just walking a road differently than we are. But one thing is for sure. It's hard to not look at the monastic and say that somehow this life, the way they're living it, is blessed by the Lord. And why do I say that? Because way more than half, I mean, I would say it's probably over 90% of the non-martyred saints of the church, even if you include some of the martyred ones too, but over 90% of the non-martyred saints of the church are monastics, are the ones that lived a ascetic life in outside of the world. They lived in monasteries. They lived in different caves. Even, maybe they didn't end their lives there, but at some point in time they did. St. John Chrysostom is a perfect example of this. He ended his life as a bishop, but he lived in a monastery at one point. St. Basil ended his life as a bishop, but he stayed in a monastery at one point. St. Gregory the Theologian, the same thing. In fact, he wanted to stay in a monastery and Basil called him out. He wanted to live, you know, a certain way. And St. Basil, his close friend, called him out of monasticism so he could be a bishop himself. And once he realized he was going to be a bishop, he ran away again. But I mean, it was just, he didn't want that. He wanted to live a peaceful, pietistic life in a monastery. And that's just not for everyone. But today, in the church, we remember all these ascetical saints. And what is the key to asceticism? The key to asceticism is taking the principal virtues, the principal disciplines of Christ, prayer, fasting, giving alms, works of mercy, that's what that giving alms is, acts of charity. It's taking those things and making them a 24-hour practice. That's what asceticism really is. That's what being a monastic really is. They pray. If you've ever been to a monastery, they're praying all the time. You can't even talk to some of them because they're praying the Jesus prayer with every breath. Even while they're doing their work, they're over here. And they're working and praying. Fasting. The second of the things that Jesus talks to us about. Fasting. When you fast, don't be like the hypocrites. They grumble. Oh my goodness, look at my fast. So that they can be seen by men. Look at how much I fast. You know, like, look at this. No one fasts like I do. Some of the Pharisees were doing. You have to fast like I fast like this. Look at the publican and the Pharisee, right? I fast twice a week. I give this. He was praying, boasting to the Lord. Jesus says when we fast, when we pray, we're not supposed to be like this. And the monastics fast, for sure. As soon as you become a monastic, you're basically saying goodbye to meat for the rest of your life. I mean, it's, you know, all that. You'll never touch it again. You'll never touch red meat. You'll never touch chicken again. It's gone. As soon as you become an Orthodox monastic, it's over. You have fish on some of the fat on some of the feast days, but other than that, kiss it goodbye. And there's reasons for that. One of the main reasons is because that those meats are so heavy they cause a soul to be tired. And a person cannot pray adequately when they have a full stomach. And it doesn't take much red meat. Anyone that has eaten a lot of hamburgers or steaks or whatever, it doesn't take much to fill you up, right? Look, you go to the restaurant and they offer these, you know, 7-8 ounce steaks. It's not a whole lot of food, but you eat it and you feel like you're full. It's just that simple, like a 1/2 pound steak. It's not even all that big. You eat it. Some people can't even finish it. So heavy. And these monastics, they just wipe it out because they don't want to be filled with food. They want to be filled with the Lord. So they're fasting. They're praying. And the last thing that a monastic does in a very strict and very wonderful way is to be hospitable. Is to be loving and hospitable to the people that come around. To offer, to love, to not say, this is mine, nothing is mine. As soon as you become a monastic, you have nothing. There is nothing that is yours anymore. That's one of the things that a monastic does. You take a vow of poverty. Everything belongs to the monastery. Everything that is yours belongs to the monastery. They will either sell it and give it to the poor, or it will be used for the benefit of the monastery. It's a beautiful thing that happens. And these are wonderful things that we have in our life that we encourage. And I'm so blessed to be growing up. I grew up as a teenager. Not before I was a teenager, but as a teenager in a place where monasticism in Greek Orthodoxy was here. Didn't happen until I was a teenager. There were no Greek Orthodox monasteries. Now, there were Orthodox monasteries, but not a whole lot of Greek Orthodox ones within the states. And it's flourishing. Even after the Greek ones, there's even more. We've got our Elwood City sisters as well as the Saxonburg ones. So, and they've been here for a while. And it's a blessing to have these people because they are not just examples in places that we can go to retreat, but they are are also offering prayers for us. So the first thing that we remember today, as we are going through all of this, as we hear the epistle, by the way, is for the monastics. The reason that epistle exists is because of the monastics. That is a monastic epistle. Anytime you hear of a monastic that is being prayed for, you will hear this epistle, where it talks about bearing one another's burdens and so fulfilling the law of Christ. Because this is what they do. These are people that don't know each other, right? These are people that are coming into this monastery. This is not their brother or their sister. Not by blood, except by the blood of Christ. These are people that don't know each other. They've never met each other. And they're being thrown into a life with one another. People always say, oh, I can never, this or that. God is this, God isn't this. This is an easy life. It's a difficult thing. One person told me, oh, a monastic of people that go get, all they do is go get fat. They pray and they eat. You want to go get fat, become a monastic. This is what somebody was telling me once. A very skeptical individual. And I just asked him a question. I said, do you have any siblings, sir? He goes, yes. I go, did you always get along with them? He said, no. I said, you were related to them, right? He goes, yeah. I go, imagine living day in and day out. If you're a headstrong person, imagine living day in and day out with a bunch of people that you have no clue who they are. You are not related to them at all. And you have to give up of yourself well every day and do what they want. Could you do this? Oh, no, that's horrible. I said, that's my master plan. It's constantly giving up what you want. It's constantly giving up what you desire for the desire of the other. When you go and try to do something for one monastic, you ask them, what do you want? And they'll say, well, one sister wants this, or one brother wants this. They won't even say, I want. Because it's not in their heart to say it that way. Or they'll say, Yaruda wants, or Yeronisa wants. Because if it's not blessed by their abbot, they can't have it. It's a life of obedience. It's a life of prayer. And it's a life that we should at least strive up to have a portion of in our lives. We're not going to be masters. But their discipline is unmatched. And it's for that reason, it's because of their discipline, it's because of their obedience, that they are largely on the pages of our Civic Society. They grace our pages of the Civic Society more than any other category of people except for the martyrs. There are not more confessors than there are monastics. Indeed, most of the confessors in the church were monastics. There are not more bishops than there are monastics. Because most of the bishops were monastics at one point. There are not more, married saints than monastics. In fact, some of the married saints became monastics later in life. We would not have the church that we have now. And forget the 400 years that the Greeks were enslaved by the Ottoman Turks. We don't like to think about those days. We don't like to think about what the Islamic regime did to our church. We don't like to think about where we would be had it not been for dedicated individuals that preserved the church. Where did that happen? In monasteries. The church, during that period of time where we were enslaved and all of those people were martyred by the Islamics, the church was preserved in monasteries. Because some of the most incredible miracles during those periods of times happened in the monasteries while the church was being preserved. We owe a lot to these ascetical people. And I am so blessed to be here serving this liturgy on a day that they are remembered. So today, we remember these wonderful and glorious saints of the church. And whether they have achieved canonization as saints really doesn't matter. They have a discipline of life that we should emulate. And they themselves look at the temptations that we have and all the opportunities to overcome them, and they are jealous of us. So it kind of feeds them the same way. So today we remember all the holy monks and nuns, and we will continue our divine liturgy at this time. In the name of the Father, and the Son, and the Holy Spirit. Again and again, please let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, have mercy.
Help us, save us, have mercy upon us, and protect us, O God, by your grace.
Lord, have mercy.
Wisdom, again, countless times we fall down before you, and we implore you, O good Lord, who loves mankind, that you, having regarded our prayer, may cleanse our souls and bodies from every defilement of flesh and spirit, and grant to us to stand before your holy altar of sacrifice, free of guilt and condemnation. Grant also, O God, to those who pray with us, progress in life, faith, and spiritual understanding. Grant that they always worship you with awe and love, partake of your holy mysteries without guilt or condemnation, and be deemed worthy of your celestial kingdom. That ever guarded by your might, we may ascribe glory to you, to the Father, to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit, now and forever, and unto the ages of ages.
Amen.
Let us complete our prayer to the Lord. For the precious gifts you presented, let us pray to the Lord.
This
holy house, and for those who enter it with faith, reverence, and the fear of God, let us pray to the Lord. For our deliverance from all affliction, wrath, danger, and distress, and necessity, let us pray to the Lord. Help us, save us, have mercy upon us, and protect us, O God, by your
grace.
For that the whole day may be perfect, holy, peaceful, and sinless, let us ask the
Lord.
For an angel of peace, a faithful guide, a guardian of our souls and bodies, let us ask the Lord. For pardon and remission of our sins and transgressions, let us ask the Lord. For that which is good and beneficial to our souls, and for peace for the world, let us ask the Lord. That we may complete the remaining time of our life in peace and repentance, let us ask the Lord. And let us ask for a Christian end to our lives, peaceful without shame and suffering, and for good defense before the awesome judgment seat of Christ. Remembering our all holy, pure, most blessed and glorious Lady, without the hopeless and ever Virgin Mary and all the saints, let us commend ourselves and one another, all our life and our whole life to Christ our God. Lord God Almighty, you alone are holy, you accept the sacrifice of praise from those who call upon you with their whole heart. Even so, accept from us sinners our supplication and bring it to your holy altar of sacrifice, us to offer you gifts and spiritual sacrifices for our own sins and the failings of your people. We must worthy to find grace in your sight that our sacrifice may be well pleasing to you, that the good spirit of your grace may rest upon us, upon these gifts presented, and upon all your people. Through the mercies of your only begotten Son, with whom you are blessed, together with your all-holy, good and life-giving Spirit, now and forever into the ages of ages.
Amen.
Peace be with you all.
And with your spirit.
Let us love one another, that with one mind we may confess.
And with your spirit.
Let us lift up our hearts.
We lift them up unto the Lord.
Let us give thanks unto the Lord.
It is proper and right.
It is proper and right to hymn you, to bless you, to praise you, to give thanks to you, and to worship you in every place of your dominion. For you, O God, are ineffable, inconceivable, invisible, incomprehensible, existing forever, forever the same. You and your only begotten Son and your Holy Spirit. You brought us out of nothing into being, and when we had fallen away, you raised us up again. You left nothing undone until you had led us up to heaven and granted us your kingdom, which is to come. For all these things, we thank you and your only begotten Son and your Holy Spirit. For all things we know and do not know, for blessings manifest and hidden that have been bestowed upon us. We thank you also for this liturgy, which you have deigned to receive from our hands, even though thousands of archangels and myriads of angels stand around you, the seraphim and cherubim, six-winged, many-eyed, soaring aloft upon their wings, singing the triumphal hymn, exclaiming, proclaiming, and saying,
Thank you.
Among the first, remember, Lord, our Archbishop and Father Silas. Grant him to your holy churches in peace, safety, honor, and health, and unto length of days or unto teaching the word of your truth. And remember those whom each one of us has in mind, and all the people. Remember, Lord, the city which we live in, and the city and the faith we live in. Remember, Lord, those who travel by land, sea, and air, the sick, the suffering, the captives, and their salvation. Remember those who bear fruit and do good works in your holy churches, and those who are the poor, and upon us all send forth your mercies. And grant that with one voice and one heart we may glorify and praise your all honorable and majestic name, of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit, now and forever into the ages of ages.
Amen.
And may the mercies of our great God and Savior Jesus Christ be with you all. Having commemorated all the saints again and again, in peace let us pray to the Lord. For the precious gifts here presented and consecrated, let us pray to the Lord. That our loving God, who loves mankind, having accepted them at his holy and celestial and mystical altar as an offering of spiritual fragrance, may in return send down upon us the divine grace and the gift of the Holy Spirit, let us pray.
Lord, have mercy.
Having asked for the unity of the faith and for the communion of the Holy Spirit, let us commend ourselves and one another and our whole life to Christ our God.
You,
we entrust to you, loving Master, our whole life and hope, and we beseech, pray, and implore you. Grant to us to partake of your heavenly and awesome mysteries from this sacred and spiritual table with a clear conscience for the remission of sins, the forgiveness of transgressions, the communion of the Holy Spirit, the inheritance of the kingdom of heaven, the boldness before you, not the judgment or condemnation. Que cataxios animas es potem et aparicias, a cataclitos de manifestaliste, se pregradio deo patera, que legi.
Our Father,
who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and give us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil.
For thine is the kingdom and the power and the glory of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit, now and forever to the ages of ages. Down from heaven, O Master, upon those who have bowed their heads before you. They have not bowed before flesh and blood, but before you, the awesome God. Therefore, O Master, make smooth and beneficial for us all whatever lies ahead, according to the need of each. Sail with those who sail, travel with those who travel, heal the sick position of our souls and bodies. Through the grace, compassion, and love for mankind, of your only begotten Son, with whom you are blessed, together with your all holy, good, and life-giving Spirit, now and forever, and unto the ages of ages.
Amen.
Mark of the Lord Jesus Christ, our God, and our most beloved, place us in the throne of the glory of your kingdom, and come to sanctify us, you who are enthroned with the Father on high, and also present among us and visibly here. And with your mighty hand, grant communion of your most pure body and precious blood to us, and to us to all. Let us be attentive. The holy gifts for the holy people of God, Tayyat Sahit, Yadaya Shati.
He is
Solos mateos nos quebrais a vivirum iantu. O God, save your people and bless your inheritance.
Thank you.
emperors, patriarchs, hierarchs, priests, higher monks, deacons, monastics, and nuns, our fathers, forefathers, grandparents, great-grandparents, parents, spouses, children, brothers and sisters, and relatives, and the servants of God, Nick, John, Muskiki, Gregory, Kalyomi, Smilia, George, Mildred, Sampi, Roberta, Georgia, Vida, Theano, Stamatulas, Nicolau, Vienes, Nicolau, Eftichia, Dimitris, Mikhail, Yurgiu, Tadis, Angelikis, Mikhail, Panayotis, Paraskevis, Dimitriou, Constantino, Yurgiu, Elias, Kalyopis, Savas, Mary, William, Ethel, Nicolau, Irini, Mary, Michael, Stavros, the priest, John, Costantino, Labrini, Lindsay, Peter, Margaret, Patricia, Costantinos, Yurgiu, Lennis, Costantinos, Theano, Michael, Kayomi, Mary, George, Panayotis, Christo, Alexandros, Michael, Michael, Mateus, Stavros, Lennis, Aguirre, Dimitriou, Xenophontos, Maria, Yurgiu, Gerasimu, Mary, Pamela, Tomet, Eleftherios, Fotini, Christo, Gabriel, Kayopis, Patelis, Arcondulas, Uranius, Tamatulas, Vasilio, Mikhail, Anastasias, Nicola, Maria, Emmanuel, Moscas, Pipinas, Yurgiu, Maria, Papa Yurgiu, Panayotis, Epinikis, Yurgiu, Sophia, Christos, Sophias, Michael, Mikhail, Nicola, Polychronium, Ioan, Panayotis, Kiriaku, Andreas, Sophias, Dalias, Chrysanto, Salani, Cristala, Salenis, Arikias, Pantelitsas, Kiriakis, Elenis, Eratos, Yurgiu, Christis, Irinis, Angelikis, Yurgiu, Elisabeth, Miltu, Nicolau, Anastasias, Vladimir, Basil, John, John, Kirill, the Archpriest, Jack, the Priest, Nicholas, Nora, Michael, John, Mary, Eleanor, Karen, George, Nicholas, the Reader, Emma, Olga, John, Roman, Julia, John, Julia, Michael, Mary, John, Victor, Paul, Theodore, Jacob, Mary, Archie, Mary, Betty, Ann, Ray, Helen, Arten, Artemis, Constantine, Helen, Stephen, Alexander, George, Bertha, George, Constantine, Stephen, and your servants, Athena, Boris, Demetrius, Michael, Theodosius, Proliathos, Erasmus, Silas, Philip, Timothy, George, Anthony, Yakov, Nicholas, the Archpriest, Michael, George, Michael, Constantine, Vladimir, George, David, George, Emmanuel, Elias, George, Spiridon, Stavros, the priest, Macrini, Taxiarchia, Senio, Nathanael, Arsenio, Macrini, Kakia, the monastics, Lemonia, Metaxia, Zelenis, Maria, Erasmia, Areti, the presbyteris, George, Desmond, Michael, Joanna, Lucas, Nicholas, Mandia, Eric, Eric, Nicolau, Yakov, John, John, Esther, Nicholas, Constantine, Emmanuel, Mary, Catherine, George, Catherine, Dimitriou, Anna, Vangelo, Philip, Constantine, Mary, Studio, Kayomi, Elizabeth, Anthony, Fokio, Isidore, George, Anastasio, Anastasio, Martinian, Marco, Paniotas, Maria, Nikis, Victoria, Jonathan, Manonda, Constantine, Oxenia, Christian, George, Alexander, Haramos, Maria, Damandio, Dorothea, Spiridon, Spiridonos, Emilias, Livias, Sophia, Paraskevis, Teres, Mark, Mary, Paul, Richard, Stavros, Mary, Peter, Maria, Haney, and from all those from the beginning of until the end of time, and for the forgiveness of all their transgressions, both voluntary and involuntary.
Amen.
In a place of refreshment,
amen.
Where there is no pain, sorrow, or suffering, As a good and loving God, forgive every sin they have committed in thought, word, or deed. There is no one who lives and does not sin. You alone are without sin. Your righteousness is an everlasting righteousness, and your law is truth. Let us pray to the Lord.
Have mercy.
For you are the resurrection, the life, and the repose of your departed servants, the pious and Orthodox Christians. O Christ our God, to you we send up glory. Together with your beginningless Father, and your all holy good and life, your Holy Spirit, now forever to the ages of ages. May your memory be eternal, dear brother, worthy of blessedness and everlasting memory. May your memory be eternal, dear brother, worthy of blessedness and everlasting memory.
Seeing that glory, we see little shreds of it.
as we go through our lives. Today is one of those days where we get to come together in a spirit of love and joy and offer that. So I'm going to pass on a dito to you. Come forward to receive your blessing. Do you have those prayers? Do you have those prayers? While you're doing this, you can read your prayers.
I know that you're doing this. You can't be wrong.
I know.
You can't be wrong.
When you've had your due and rightful part, his life-giving and mysterious gifts, you've immediate praise and great thanks to God, and say the following with fervent soul, glory to your God, glory to your God, glory to your God.
I thank you, Lord my God, that you have not rejected me, a sinner, but have made me worthy to partake of the whole mystery. I thank you that you have permitted me, although I'm unworthy, to receive your glory and heavenly gifts. O loving Master, who guided our words for our sake, grant to us the awesome life. You who have voluntarily given me your flesh as food, who are holding heart to the unworthy, do not consume me to know my Creator, but rather penetrate into my members, all my joints, my veins, my heart, and burn my thorns, all my iniquities, cleanse my soul, hallow my thoughts, and confirm my need for my bones and sweat, illumine my five senses, and make my entire being vigilant for the fear of you, while truly you always should protect me from every deed and word. So, cleanse me, purify my glory, and word, and Lord, may give me an understanding and illuminate. Mark me that you're calling faith, that the Spirit won't be no longer a place of sin, so that when you enter, as if into your own home, you know that the people do it, and every passion will flee from you, from the fire. As an advocate, that brings you to all the things that you have missed. And the incorporeal host, your forerunner, your wives, your apostles, and women, these, your fathers, your mother, whose prayers accept my compassion in Christ, make your servant a child of life. For your goodness, you alone have to find the life in our souls, and you are God, the Master, who we give, as it is right. Glory of the dead. Lord Jesus Christ, my God, let the Lord say to God, and be unto me for eternal life and the precious blood for forgiveness of sin. Let this Eucharist be up to me for joy, health, and gladness, and in your awesome second coming, make me a sinner worthy to stand at the right hand of your glory through the intercession of your pure mother and of all your saints. Amen. All holy Lady, feel Jehovah's light of my darkened soul, my hope, shelter, refuge, comfort, and joy. I thank you for you have deemed me the unworthy one, worthy to partake of your most pure body and of the precious blood of your Son. That you, who gave birth to the true light and life in the spiritual eyes of my heart, you conceived the source of immortality and will give life to me who am dead in sin. You, the compassionate mother of the merciful God, have mercy on me and give me penitence and good contrition, a heart of meekness in my thoughts and an awakening of my thoughts from captivity. And grant me until my last breath to receive without condemnation of sanctification. sanctification of your sacred mysteries for the animals worldwide. Grant me tears of repentance and confession, not in prayer, Lord, but in all the days of my life. For you are blessed and most glorified to the ages. Amen.
You are blessed and most greatly glorified to the ages. Amen.
For you are blessed and most glorified to the ages. Amen.
Master, now let your servant depart in peace according to the word of my eyes and your salvation. If you have prepared for the presence of all people, a light to the light of the Gentiles, the glory of your people is yours.
Holy God, holy mighty, holy Lord, have mercy on us. Holy God, holy mighty, holy Lord, have mercy on us. Holy God, holy mighty, holy Lord, have mercy on us. Glory to the Father, and the Son, and the Holy Spirit, now and forever, to the age of ages. Amen. All holy Trinity, have mercy on us, Lord, forgive our sins, and as we part of our transgressions, holy Lord, visit and be all from these for new days. Lord, have mercy, Lord, have mercy, Lord, have mercy. Glory to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit, now and ever, to the ages of ages. Amen. Our Father, Lord, in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not to temptation, but deliver us from evil.
For that is the kingdom, the power, and the glory of the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit, now and ever, to the ages of ages.
Amen. First, let the flame shine forth from your mouth as a lumen of the universe and its treasures of poverty. And show us the height of humility in this by your words you teach us, Father John, which is to intercede with the word of Christ our God to save our souls. Glory to the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit. And receive God and grace from heaven you teach all the men to the Lord and one God in three verses, all Apostle John, your sister. Do not be afraid, we praise you, for you are our Lord, and you feel in all things divine. Let it not happen to the ages of ages. Amen. The protection of Christians unashamed, who are accessory to our holy maker, unwavering, and reject not the prayerful Christ of us who are in sin, instead come to us from your heaven, your loving help, and come to us who are crying and face to you. Hasten to intercede and speed now to supplicate the protection for all time that focus for those who honor you. Lord, have mercy, 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 Lord, have mercy. Glory to the Father, and the Son, and the Holy Spirit, with now and ever, to the ages of ages. Amen. O God of our fathers, since all you always deal with us in accordance with your gentleness, do not withdraw your mercy from us, but have your fervent entreaty.
May God be gracious unto us and bless us, may cause his face to shine upon us, and have mercy upon us. Glory to your God, and I hope glory to you. Prayers of the Holy Father, for Jesus Christ, our God, have mercy upon us and save us.
Amen.